In this lesson, I'm going to give you a quick tour of Immutable.js. So here we have a basic JavaScript code. We have a book object with a title property. We have a function called publish. It gets a book object and set its publish property to true. Next, we call this function and then log this book on the console. Pretty straightforward. Now, when practicing functional programming, we don't want to mutate objects. So this is where we can use Immutable.js. Immutable.js provides a bunch of immutable data structures. So instead of using a plain JavaScript object, we're going to use one of the data structures provided by Immutable.js. So first, open up your terminal window and run npm install immutable. Okay, so I'm using Immutable version 4.0. Now, back to this code. On the top, we need to import the map function from the immutable library. With this map function, we can create a map or hash map. That's like a regular JavaScript object. It's a container for key value pairs. But this map object that we get from this library is immutable. So now, instead of using this plain JavaScript object, we're going to call the map function to get a map object. Now, let me temporarily comment out this code. So we create a map object and log it on the console. Take a look. So this is what we get. This is not a regular book object. It has a bunch of weird properties like size, root, owner ID, and so on. So this is the first problem with this library. If we want to log the title of a book, we cannot access the title property using the dot or bracket notation. We have to call the get method, get title. Save the changes. There you go. So the first problem with this library is that we have to learn a whole new API. Now, this API is not that complex. You can learn it pretty quickly. But in my opinion, the main problem is that it's hard to integrate this with other libraries that expect plain JavaScript objects. Every time we need to work with plain JavaScript objects, we have to call the to.js method. So this returns a plain JavaScript object. Now let's bring this code back in. So when publishing a book, we want to set its publish property to true. To do this using immutable, we have to call the set method. So set is published to true. Now, this is not going to modify the original book object. It's going to return a new object because all these map objects are immutable, like strings in JavaScript. So here we have to return the result. We publish the book, and then we can reassign the book variable, and then we can convert it to a plain JavaScript object and log it on the console. Take a look. So here's the result. So here's Immutable.js in action. As you can see, once you start using it, it gets spread out everywhere in your code base. Everywhere you have to use these getters and setters or convert immutable data structures to plain JavaScript objects. That is why I personally prefer Immer. We're going to talk about that next.